Welcome to another episode. I'm Adrian DeLuca. Today, we're going to talk about bulk data transfer into the cloud. This could be for log or transactional data, for analysis, post-processing, or content distribution. And users could be literally coming from anywhere around the world. Well, it turns out that S3, or the simple storage service, is perfect for this. Here's a common interaction. You've got users coming in over the internet, uploading their files via a HTTP put, with those files being stored as objects in an S3 bucket. Now, there's a couple of considerations. First, how do you manage identity and access? Second, how do you secure the data once it's there? Third, how do you implement detective controls? You know, the stuff that the security folks tell us to do for auditing and logging. And finally, how do you onboard new users? Identifying your users and what they have access to is really important from a security perspective. A common anti-pattern that I see is creating the credentials using the secret access keys and distributing them directly to the users. It's not a good idea because if they leave their organization, they can take those credentials with them and still have access to the data. This is where the Identity Access Management Service comes in. It allows you to define specific actions that can be performed on those resources. So if we look at the pattern here, you're going to create IAM users, group them together, and assign a role with a policy that restricts them only to the functions that they can do. In this case, a HTTP put. This gives you the flexibility to add, remove users really easily. Another thing that you want to add to the IAM policy is to lock down the location from where they're coming from. So using the source IP condition key can restrict the IP address of where they can upload their files from. And finally, we also want to monitor the policy for changes. Here we can create an AWS config custom rule to be able to pick up those changes. If we see that the keys are no longer being used, we can trigger an alert and then, using a Lambda function, remove those users' keys. Next, we're going to look at how you secure the data. Amazon S3 provides server-side encryption by default with Amazon managed keys, but you can bring your own master keys as well. Going back to the pattern, these are all stored in the AWS key management service, so it's something that you don't have to worry about. Now, we talked a little bit about IAM before. Here is where we can lock down the objects and resources that they have access to using access controls. To be able to identify different organizations, you may want to think about using prefixes and delimiters. Also, if you find that you need to maintain multiple copies of the data, you can switch on versioning. And if you want to provide users a custom URL, you can use the S3 access point service. One thing that I definitely recommend is that you tag all your objects for good practice. Implementing detective controls allows us to identify potential security threats as well as incidents that have happened. So the first thing you want to do is enable monitoring and collect some usage metrics from all the different services that you're using. So for that, switch on CloudWatch. This enables us to keep a close eye on all the performance thresholds inside of your architecture. To track access and changes to objects, CloudTrail helps us keep track of all the different calls that have happened for audit purposes. ElasticSearch is really great to comb through all the S3 logs, help correlate events, and find anomalies that have happened. And finally, if your data is subject to governance or compliance, or you just want to stay away from storing personally identifiable information, Amazon MACI can really come in handy. So far, we've looked at how to identify different users, what they have access to, and how to secure your data, as well as the detective controls that help manage the environment. But what about onboarding your users? Here, you may want to think about creating a little web app, one that allows your users to log in, create their profiles, and assign different access and permissions. If they're integrating it into an existing application through an API, you may also want to think about using an organizational LDAP, something like Active Directory. Or you could use Amazon Cognito to manage the user pool. Check out the resources below for more details. And thanks for tuning in.